Hi guys, Mr. SCC as usual for Onus Radio Fuzzy. And today I'm gonna show you how to create a dish rack to add over your sink. Made of slat bed frame and some glow-in-the-dark epoxy resin. Alright, let's go and make it happen.
For this dish rack, I've used slat bed frames that I found in the street in my neighborhood, and I've decided to create something out of it instead of leaving them there. Here, I am measuring the wood thickness before going to my planer to bring the first three slats to 14 cm thickness. Okay, let's say almost 14 cm. Then I went over the other three to bring them to 7 cm thickness. Okay, again, almost 7 cm. After that, I'm ripping the side pieces just to have a clean side. Not that they were first measuring 6 cm wide, then I decided to bring them to 4 cm wide to start working with those. And here we are, all cleaned and all cut. Then after that, I went to the kitchen to mark the width of the thing over the board to get the right dimensions to be able to easily slide the rack over the sink. And there is another mark to make the inside cut that will prevent it from sliding out. Then I finish by taking the mark to create some notches that will be cut using my scroll saw. One of the nice things with the scroll saw is that you can always make some precise cuts, depending on the design you're looking for. From the other thinner board, I will be tracing and cutting several dividers that will be directly placed between each bigger board. After cutting all dividers, I'm here placing them to have a first look at the design, but please keep in mind that you could also use any pattern you want to make it your own. Then, to make this design unique but also very attractive, especially at night, I have decided to create several 22mm holes in each board in order to insert some glow-in-the-dark epoxy resin. And once again, you could dispose them as you want as soon as they are not created at the same position as your small dividers. And now, it's time to prepare the board with the tapes to insert the epoxy. Note here that I've decided to use a light blue for the middle boards and a dark one for the side ones. Now that they are all dry, time to smooth the edges and each side before moving to the next steps. To sand them all, I have decided to use here my belt sander, first with a 40 grit sandpaper as I needed to really scratch out the solid epoxy. Then I have moved to a 150 grit sandpaper to smooth each board sides. After sanding them all, I'm using a wet towel to remove the dust on them. Then, time to assemble them all using some very strong wood glue. I put wood glue on both sides of the dividers and then started to glue the boards together. And if needed, do not hesitate to use a small brush to spread the glue all over the space. I have to say that this is really a precise job. And if you decide to create the same, feel free to use some measurement tools to make sure each divider is at the same level. And finally, the sideboards, which are a little bit thinner than the middle ones. To hold them together, I'm using some clamps that will stay on until the glue is dried. Now that they are all glued to each other, I'm going to remove the imperfections by sanding it again with a 40 grit, then a 150 grit sandpaper. To finish, I will be using some transparent lacquer that I will apply twice to make sure the wood is protected against the water drops. Et voilà! Here you have a nice dish rack that can be used over your sink to cut, serve some coffee or tea or anything you could think of. And without forgetting the glow-in-the-dark effect that could make it even more attractive to use.
And as I'm trying to show you in most of my videos, recycling can be much more easier than we think. With a little bit of ideas and some times, we could avoid trashing a lot of things. I will make sure to show you again and again some of the ideas that I'm using for myself, hoping that this will inspire you to have another idea of housing. Sure guys, what is helping us to create more video content for you is the fact that you're supporting us by sharing our 1 minute to recycle video. I have to thank all of you because this is really helping in creating more awareness around recycling and refurbishing on a daily basis. Mr. LTC as usual for another video of housing. If you're a newbie to the channel, I will be glad to show you even more every week if you subscribe just right here. And don't forget to click after that on the bell so you will get a notification every time I'm uploading new content and you won't miss out on any of the fun. Alright, thanks for watching and see you next time!